So I'm going to give an overview about what is happening in Amrita. Basically, I'll be covering the Amrita School of Engineering. We have the Amrita University has the School of Business, School of Medicine, and all that. And we're not doing this 101 for the other schools. So basically, we're just going to cover what we're doing in the engineering school. Basically, whatever was asked to be presented will have all these. So before I go, the reason I'm stating this is we need to know the scale so that how we are going to be doing it in Amrita. We have three campuses in the Amrita School of Engineering, one in Coimbatore, which is in Tamil Nadu, one in Amritapuri, which is in Kerala, which is near Kollam, and the third one is in Bangalore. So in total, we are taking around 2,300 first years every year for engineering. So this is spread across these three campuses. So we'll have around 1,000 students, at least in the Coimbatore campus, because which is the biggest campus. So this is the scale. And what we do in Amrita is that we have a common syllabus for all these three campuses, especially for IIT 101. Introduction to programming is done for both first semester and second semester. We do 101 in first semester, and then C++ is done in the second semester. And it's for all departments. So the syllabus is basically set by a group of experts. That is decided, I think, and it is remodified every 2-3 years. And that is determined by the academic council. But how the syllabus and how this program is implemented every year is based on one a team, which is pretty much the IIT 101 team. And in addition, we also have a regular faculty development program, especially for this course, which is conducted by the Department of IT in Amrita, in Coimbatore. So they're planning to have this session coming June for all the faculty who will be teaching this computer programming. So one of the goals is to take this, what we are going to be doing in this course, and also try to see if we can merge those faculty development programs so that they can benefit from this too. So the IT 101 team has a chief course mentor who will be the most experienced or senior most faculty who has taught this subject. And this can be from any one of these three campuses. And we have a campus mentor for each of these campuses. So we'll have three campus mentors. And we have 10 faculty each from each school. So this is the group. And in addition, we'll have some other faculty who will be assisting in labs for the IT. So before the semester starts, there is a meeting held for all these people who are in that team. And they come up with a common lecture plan, common evaluation pattern, which is common to all the campuses. And only the chief mentor can modify any of this. But how they want to structure the periodical tests, labs, quizzes, that can be done based on the different campuses. And they collaborate with the campus mentors approval. So that is how it happens. And final exam is where it takes a lot of the work, because each of the campuses comes up with a question paper. And then the chief mentor resolves any issues between these three question papers and then sends them to the chief examiner. One question paper is chosen and is given to all the campuses. And then evaluation of this exam is done by all the faculty who are teaching this course. It's a lot of work, but some percentage of the questions are graded by all the faculty so that there is no bias among the campuses. So that will be a lot of work in terms of the final exam grading. But once the evaluation is done, grading is done again according to the institutes. So if Coimbatore has its own grading system, it's all relative. And it's done in the individual campuses. So this is the syllabus we are teaching. It has the introduction to problem solving. There'll be a little bit of introduction to algorithmic development, flowchart, which is very basic level introductions. And then you go into C fundamentals. You have data types, expressions, and loops, and all those fundamentals of programming. And then we go into arrays, user-defined functions, pointers, structures, and finally files. One thing I forgot to mention is IT 101, there is two components. One is the theory session and one is the lab session. And I'll come to how these different things are structured. So the course schedule is as follows. You have theory sessions of 45 hours. Then we have 10 tutorial sessions, which is again optional. And if there are more slots, we can vary this. Then we have 12 lab sessions. And the scale is that we have about 16 batch of 65 students each in Coimbatore. This is the what we have there. And we have lab mentors for each of these labs. And we have computers, enough computers to support students one-on-one. And if there are students who are not having the necessary fundamentals of C, and because they come from, say, biology background or something like that, then we'll also have some special tutorial classes on demand basis. So the evaluation scheme, I can go into a little bit of the lecture sessions. This is how it is broken down, where you have module one, you have introduction, control structures, and we spend 10 hours for that. Then we have arrays, we spend around 8 hours. Then we have periodicals, functions, pointers, 12 hours. Then structures for 10 hours, and files another 10 hours. So this is how it is.
Periodical
is that intermediate midterm evaluation kind of thing. So we have, usually we have two periodicals. So for the evaluation scheme is as follows. Theory, we have periodical exams, and we evaluate 35% of it. Then there is class tests and online exams. Most of these are done using Amrita University Management System, which is a management system developed at Amrita. But I believe that one of the campuses is using Moodle. So it looks like we'll be using Moodle also in the other campuses. And then there is open book exams for 5%, and then there's a final exam. For the lab, this is the structure for the lab, and there is assignment and online test, which is 45%. They also have a mini project, which they have to do, which mostly includes file structures, and they have to do some simple project. But the most important importance is laid on what is the fundamentals, and have they understood programming, more than the complexity of the project. And then they have some evaluation for the project report, and they have a final exam. Final exam is compulsorily held for all the courses.
In this slide, mm-hmm. You have a total weightage of 100% sort of marks for theory.
Yes.
And an equal weightage for the lab as well.
Yes.
Okay.
I think the units are, I think it is two. So in each of these labs, we've been given assignments. And so we have these 12 sessions over the entire semester. So the algorithms, if you give us assignment for that particular lab, then what we will be doing, this is how the labs are evaluated. We have algorithms, they have 10 marks for that. Flowchart, they have 10. Then the source code, they have 30. Then output is 25. And then we also have two extra lab assistants who will be doing the Viva and all that. So there'll be 20 for that. And finally, programming etiquette. We insist on commenting and all that, so we do give some marks for that. We are trying to bring our own standards for how to comment, but we do insist on commenting. So quizzes and online tests, we use the AUMS in Coimbatore. In Amritapuri, I think they use both AUMS and the Moodle. These are some of the examples. This is, I think, from Amritapuri. It is one of the first year assignment. This is one of the implementation. And then other example, this is from Coimbatore, other lab questions. I have some 5-6 lab exams, assignment questions. And so I can show some samples. So for example, these are some sample programs from, so there's multiplication tables, then a lot of menu-driven programs and palindromes. Mathematical, we get various, and there is a sample quiz. We try to do something like output of the codes. We give some code snippets. This can be done online. Then they are supposed to try to do how to find this. So this they can take online, and we are providing facilities for this. This is a sample periodical. The periodical is a little bit more. It's a lot of little bit theory and little bit programming. So there's a combination of questions in the periodicals. So this is a sample question paper again from Amritapur. So lab environment, we have across the campuses, we have around 3,000 to 4,000 machines, and we have our own even supercomputers. So we have a very good lab environment, and we make sure that every student has one-to-one access. If we provide Linux machines for the labs, and each student has an account in a Linux server for the duration of the semester. They are programming using Vim editor and GCC, and we use GDB for preliminary debugging. They don't do very advanced debugging. And then we also teach multi-file compilation and how to do makefile and all those. And we also have an exam login, and where you will be giving a fixed duration login so that students will be only logging in at that time for their lab assignments. So we are also trying to enhance our system so that students cannot cheat or use their internet and other facilities to copy the programs. So we have any questions?
So as you said, the teaching environment, by the way, you have LCD projectors and all in the classroom?
Not in all classrooms, but they do use, if you want
to. So they use blackboard or white?
Mostly blackboards.
Blackboard.
I think they also use transparencies.
Overhead projectors. And what is the class strength typically in a class?
60.
60. Mm. So the same, as you're saying, batch size.
Batch size, yeah. I think for labs, the batch sizes are smaller.
And how many teachers are there? Totally, you said 10 plus 10 plus 10.
30.
And in the three campuses?
In the three campuses. So because we have around 1,000 students per campus, yes. Almost.
I was just saying that if you have 10 teachers, then how 1,000 teachers means it will be a batch of 100 or you have more batches?
16 batches of 65 students each. This is in Coimbatore.
Oh, 16 batches.
Yes.
Okay, so some teachers will have to teach two batches.
Yes. I think some of them are doing the teaching and think they have extra load, but we'll have more faculty for the labs. So we have lab mentors for each lab and we have extra faculty who will be doing labs.
Lab mentors are not just technical staff.
No, we'll be faculty.
So
yes.
Programming, I mean they can.
Yes.
And like Urjita said, you also don't have adequate number of MTech or PhD students to provide TAship.
Actually, we are right now, I think, because we are slowly starting the PhD program, we are taking in-house PhDs. That is, people who are doing, who are faculty members, MTech, they are doing PhDs.
So you can't count them twice, I mean. It doesn't.
Exactly.
But you don't have enough ME.
MTech students, not really.
Using them.
We are not using them.
And when you said special classes for students without necessary background, so do you presuppose some background on part of the students when they come? Or, suppose I have absolutely no clue about programming. I should, because the syllabus that you mentioned, you're starting from ground zero actually.
Right.
So there should be no background that I should be required to have at all. Now, what are the books that you use? Kanigan and Richie, I could see K are there.
Yes.
Except that there is another edition by KR. It's not 1992 anymore, but that's okay.
I think this they have sent me the older version.
Yeah, then Venugopal and standard thing. So introduction, arrays, pointers, structures, files are pretty much similar to what we saw elsewhere.
Yes.
Except that at Vellore they handle pointers and files in the second semester.
Yes.
Any other questions friends have here on this? So this is, and do you also have a follow-up course? Isn't this course taught to all branches?
All branches.
Not just CS or IT?
No, everyone. Right. That is where we are having problems because we are, the IT, the students who are going into CSE want more depth so that they can learn better. But then there is how much to cover and how much not to cover so that we are in the process of decongesting the first year. So that we don't want to burden the students already. So there is a question as to do we reduce the amount of syllabus covered in programming, but then it affects the computer science students. So that's the thing that is going on right now.
And roughly what is your semester schedule in a year? When does the first semester begin and end?
I think around end of July.
End of July.
Mid-July.
Yeah. End of July. That's the IIT timetable also, by the way. But at some places, the semester begins in June, I'm told. Is it any month of July? Okay. That's another worry we have, because we have planned this course, this workshop, from 6th July to 22nd July. So whether because at least from the Maharashtra, our experience is that the admissions to first year get delayed. So the first year courses typically start, in fact, sometimes August.
Yes. August. I think first year will start late.
So therefore, the teachers who are going to teach first year courses should be free during 6th July to 22nd July. That is what we are pursuing. And even those cases where the semesters start regularly, such as yours, you start only around the last week of July.
Yes.
So 6th to 22nd should work out well.
I think so. I can confirm that.
What I wanted to know, because you have at three different centers, including Bangalore.
Yes.
Would you be able to take the material that we have covered here, including video lectures, etc., etc., and conduct a similar program or have discussions with two of your colleagues from these two campuses so that they could conduct at each of these centers a program like this for 30 teachers?
Yes.
That should be possible.
That should be possible.
10 of them would be from your own place.
Yes. Yes, yes.
Could be, I mean, if they are interested. Because ordinarily, I would like to have about 30 to 40 centers. In fact, ideally, we could have 50 centers. See, this is a scalable proposition.
Right, right.
So, less number of teachers at one place, but more number of centers would be better. But we can't afford that, and we need to show results to the mandarins in Delhi. So we have to be able to scale this up to maybe as many as 500 teachers if possible.
Okay.
And if we have only 10 centers, we may not be able to do that. So if we increase the centers, and this is a request to colleagues here, that in cities like Pune, Nagpur, wherever you can, if you can actually have more centers, and somehow a person can coordinate effectively, so you should have a coordinator from the other colleges also. But for example, I would regard you as the coordinator in chief of the three campuses, kind of thing.
Okay.
So what you should do is you should get at least three other colleagues involved, not just two from the other two campuses, but one more at your own place itself. And you should be able to handle issues pertaining to all the three campuses, something of that sort. That's what I'm going to suggest to Venkat.
Okay.
If that is possible, that would be very nice.
Okay.
Okay. All right. Thank you, Vidya.